Hello friends, how are you? This is Mudassar from Phoneer. Well, Vivo Y33S promises a powerful battery and a great camera. And they say that phone looks very beautiful. It's a new device from Vivo in the lower mid-range category. Let's unbox the device first and see how amazing the phone is and what's my first impression about this device. Vivo Y series is quite a busy range of smartphones that offers us so many choices. Y20, Y31, Y51S, Y53S and now Vivo Y33S. Many of them have some common features, but there is a major distinction in them, the camera module. So we are getting a charger that can go up to 18 watts maximum. We have a Type-C cable. This phone gives us a Type-C 2.0 support. Well, earphones are a welcome sign for music lovers. And here you get the rear silicone case that is must for a delicate phone. As usual, it is transparent, good quality and flexible. And here we go with the phone. Let's take a look at the back panel first. There are lots of hues and textures here, and it looks a stylish looking phone. This one in my hands is midday dream with an embossed AG texture. You can see a very frosty feel here. There is an additional liquid crystal coating for adding smoothness and also keep the fingerprint smudges away. The power key also serves as the fingerprint sensor. This one is not too grooved, but still it is a little indent. I can call it more or less flat, but it is enough prominent and cannot be missed. The volume keys are rightly placed and very clicky. Well, another highlighting feature of this phone is the slimness. It is actually 8.0mm slim and about 182g in weight. On the top, you are getting the SIM tray that can house 2 nano SIMs and an extra SD card up to 1TB, which is a lot of memory. The bottom holds the usual control, so nothing special here. Well, coming back to the triple camera setup, the look of it's now common on Vivo phone. We have seen it on so many other Vivo phones, but it looks very well adjusted. Actually, it adds to the beauty of the phone. It does not stick out much and does not cause wobbling on flat surface, which is also a good balance of design and beauty. The top lens is 50 megapixel and it gives the 1.8 aperture size. And then we have two more lenses here, a 2 megapixel bokeh and 2 megapixel macro that are expected as usual. Both of them are giving 2.4 aperture value. Let's see how the silicone cover looks like. Let's put it here. It's very easy and smooth and it just slips right away. And look at the back panel, it still shines the same way. Here on the front, the bezels are not very prominent and disturbing. And apart from the bottom area, which is always a little louder than the rest of the sides due to several components inside, the phone looks great in this category. On the top here, you are getting this notch and inside a 16 megapixel front camera. Sliding my fingers across this 6.58 inches screen is a smooth experience for me. It's a 60Hz refresh rate on this display that is 1080 into 2408 pixel resolution. I can see the brightness level is quite reasonable and colors are vivid on the screen. There is a blue light filter available that will less harm your eyes, but you have to activate it from the display settings. So here is one of the highlighting features of the phone. It offers an 8GB RAM, but you can also get a 4GB extra RAM which system takes from the available ROM. So this 12GB RAM tries to give a smoother performance at the time of multitasking. You get Android 11 and FunTouch 11.1 on this phone, and there is a Helio G80 chipset running the show. Actually, FunTouch 11.1 is more simple and minimal design now. I think the combination of total RAM and this gaming chipset is really interesting. You are also getting all the major sensors including the gyroscope on this phone. The fingerprint sensor is quick and so is the face unlock feature. The HyperEngine gaming technology also supports the gaming session by allocating the required resources on your phone. Then you have Multi-Turbo 5.0 that also supports gaming and power saving. Vivo tells the cooling system actually comprises of four components: graphite cooling plate, high heat conductivity copper foil, heat conducive gel, cooling turbo intelligent heat dissipation management system. And there is a 4D gaming vibration system, but it only applies to PUBG. Well, another highlighting feature is the battery. There is a 5000mAh battery and an 18 watt fast charge that is coming with this phone. While talking about the camera interface, the default camera app has improved over time on Vivo phones. All the major tools are right where they should be. There is no wide angle feature here this time, but we are getting usual bokeh and macro modes. You can turn on the 50 megapixel mode from here, but you can also see a few more features, for example slow-mo or pro mode. You can make up to 1080p videos on front and rear side. The front gives Aura screen flash, but it is not available for videos. Let's take a look at some of the pictures I shot from this phone, and here they are. For now, I can say the pictures are good and bright, although I have clicked just a few shots. But inshallah, I will definitely do a detailed camera and battery review of this phone. So guys, wait for it on Phoneer in the coming days. Well, I think it should be an amazing device for Vivo fans. For the short time I've used this phone, I think it appears that the phone can give a very good battery backup and the camera should be a performer. And above all, the phone looks really good. So what is your opinion about this phone? Which feature do you like the most? Do let me know in the comment area. Please like this video and please don't forget to subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Until my next video, Allah Hafiz.